My students, today we are starting theoretical perspectives and we'll review the concept of theory. Theory is basically the ultimate purpose of science. Ultimate purpose of scientific enterprise is to create a theory. A theory is basically a claim to explain something. And of course, it is a mental activity. And if we use the word in its original sense, we always tend to theorize. Human beings always make theories that how things work, how this world is working, why 9/11 happened, for example, why coronavirus, for example. So we can have different theories, which, for example, say that these are conspiracy theories, but they are still theories. A theory is basically a mental activity through which we explain a phenomenon. We observe certain things and then we develop some concepts and then we join those concepts to create a statement, and that is a theory. So you can also think of theory as a story. For example, if I observe something that Mr. X is doing something, and after some time I again observe that he's doing something, and then again I observe that his behavior. Now, by joining my observations and by having access to some other data, I can make a mental map, a chart. That would be my theory. I would explain that why he is doing that, for example, right? So we always make theories in our family life, in our social life, in our political and religious life. We always develop theories. Sociology is concerned with understanding how society works. So the ultimate purpose of sociological enterprise is to understand society. So development of theory is the ultimate aim. Ultimate aim of physics, for example, is to understand how matter and energy are related, for example. And so that would be the theory, that would be the ultimate explanation, and it would keep on refining after observation and experimentation. So method, scientific method and theory are interrelated. Research and theory are interrelated. We do research in the context of a theory. Because if we just create data and we have a lot of data, we need to interpret that data, right? So theory would help us in understanding and in interpreting our data. That interpretation would depend on our theoretical assumptions, right? So whenever we do some research, you will make some research in your various courses at FC College. So you will be required in your research to state clearly which theoretical perspective you will be using. So in PhD level, you will be doing research. You will have to clearly state your theoretical assumptions about your research. So research and theory are related. So when we do some research, our research findings may have consequences on our theory. So we can revise our theory in the light of our findings, that this theory is not able to explain this. So the real power of a theory, my dear students, is its explanatory power and its power to predict something. So if we encounter a phenomena which is not being explained by previous theory, so we need another theory, it means. We need to refine theory. So this is how theoretical development keeps on going, and that is the ultimate aim of science. So research and theory are related, and this is the ultimate aim of science. So in sociology, we will discuss some theories, some theoretical perspectives. A perspective is basically same thing. A perspective is basically a theoretical framework. In sociology, there are certain questions we have discussed in the class. What is society? What is science? How society should be studied? What should be the role of sociologist in society, whether he should be value free or whether he should be neutral, or he should be actively engaging with creating ideal society. So to what extent sociology is science? On all these questions, there can be various responses. So these responses would determine a particular perspective. So this is how different perspectives emerged in sociology. And these perspectives are present in every science. In physics, we have perspectives. In literature, we have perspectives. So sociology, I mean, whenever human beings engage in some study, they develop perspectives. And this is the beauty of pursuing any knowledge, that we develop more than one ways, we develop more than one lenses to see society. So a perspective is basically a lens. A perspective is basically a story. A perspective is basically a portrait. For example, if I ask you to draw society, so you will be drawing society on paper in a different ways. Some of you might draw, for example, a picture of a tree. The society is like a tree. It has roots, it has plant, it has leaves, it has fruit. Some of you might draw society like a train, that it has an engine and all other bogies, and it is compartmentalized, emphasizing the social stratification. Some would draw like a people in a circle joining hands, for example. So all these drawings basically reflect your basic assumptions about society. So this is how different perspectives are. We will be discussing many perspectives in the future, soon, inshallah. Thank you very much.